funny thing about the Doctor being accused of genocide at the end of this episode is that it's kind of hard to argue. As a heroic character, he's committed genocide a surprising number of times. Welcome to the Time Treadmill. I'm Ron, and these are my sweaty thoughts about Doctor Who. I'll get back to the genocide thing in a second, but first, the most interesting thing to me about the Terror of the Vervoid segment of Trial of a Time Lord is that not only is it an Agatha Christie pastiche, but it's also an alien invasion story. The problem is, the existence of the alien invasion is completely masked by the Agatha Christie-style murders. As the bodies keep piling up, there is a legitimate conspiracy going on that is ultimately revealed to be an aging employee who's miffed at being summarily retired and decides to sweeten his pension, so to speak. But the thing is, his plot coincides with the fact that these sentient plant creatures have started cutting loose and killing people all over the ship, and their activity is completely masked by the other plot that's going on. There's so much subterfuge and twists and turns and 10 Little Indians-style mystery that these bipedal triffids go completely unnoticed until nearly the last section of the story. It's only once this initial plot is revealed and the Starliner avoids flying into the most visible and colorful black hole in the history of the universe, that the Vervoids finally come to the fore and have to be dealt with. And yes, the Doctor does indeed commit genocide. He uses some magical whatever mineral to create bombs that generate an overflow of light and carbon dioxide that accelerates the aging of the plant creatures, so they all suffer through autumn and wither and die and blow away like leaves in the fall. It's almost comical when the Doctor is offended at the end when in the courtroom drama the Valyard accuses him of genocide, because yeah, that's basically what he did, and it's the same thing the Doctor will do again in the future. He certainly believed he committed genocide against both the Time Lords and the Daleks for quite a long period of time, and there have been other cases along the way. Again, is just kind of surprising for being the character who is moral and ethical and heroic and everything that you should admire to. But that's one of the things I love about this show, is the complexities and nuance for what is nominally a children's pantomime half-hour drama. I mean, it's on its surface, it's not meant to be taken seriously, and yet, like all of the best children's fiction, it contains much deeper truths that children really can begin to grasp and understand. And so, once again, we come back to why do I love Doctor Who? And it's not so much that he commits genocide, it's that the moral struggle and ambiguity of the situation is even addressed in the first place. So, that wraps it up for all of the story segments. Tomorrow I get to the big finale of the Trial of the Time Lord, where the ultimate foe is revealed and the Sixth Doctor regenerates and Colin Baker is unceremoniously booted off the program so badly that he actually refuses to come back for his post-regeneration scene. And honestly, who could blame him? I'll see you tomorrow.